Hi, this is Dale from the CurrentWare team. Today, I'm going to show you how to get started with monitoring employee productivity, web browsing, and application usage with BrowseReporter's User Activity Reports. These reports work in tandem with BrowseReporter's User Activity Dashboards to provide you with advanced awareness of your users' computer usage across your organization. This video will cover the key activity monitoring features of BrowseReporter, including sample computer activity reports, how to get insights into the computer usage history of specific users or computers, how to automate sending reports to email addresses on a set schedule, how to get alerts related to your users' computer activity, how to take screenshots of your users' desktops, and finally, an overview of BrowseReporter's privacy-focused options such as how to limit what data is collected, how to alert your users if they are being tracked, and how to share an individual's user activity data with them. This video will not cover BrowseReporter's user activity dashboards. Those will be covered in another video. This demo will be using version 7.0.1, so there may be small differences if you are using another version. Before watching this video, you should already have the CurrentWare web console set up, the CurrentWare clients installed on the computers you would like to manage, and your users or computers placed in their own policy groups. For more information on installing CurrentWare and setting up your policy groups, please visit the knowledge base at currentware.com/support. All right, let's get started. BrowseReporter allows you to create reports on demand, at a set schedule, or when specific events occur. In this section, I'll cover how to generate a user activity report on demand in BrowseReporter. First, click on Run Report. Under Report Type, you will see the available reports. BrowseReporter's user activity reports have four distinct categories, each with their own reports. Websites visited, categories visited, bandwidth usage, and application usage. For this example, we'll use the Sites Visited report. Each report type will have slightly different configuration options available. For the Sites Visited report, you can display in-office versus remote time based on the IP address of the network the user is browsing from. For this feature to work, you must have the location tracking feature set up with all of your in-office IP addresses included. To learn more about this feature, please visit the CurrentWare knowledge base at currentware.com/support. You can include web page titles to provide more context to their browsing activity. Configure the report to display all unique URLs, domains only, or specific URLs. Select the users or computers you'd like to include in the report. When you select the user mode, it'll include all PCs used by that user in the report. If you select PC mode, you'll run reports on that specific PC, referencing any user profiles that have used that PC previously. Choose the reporting period to limit the data to a specific time period, such as today, yesterday, the last N days, last month, a custom date range, or all time. Expand the additional settings to set data sorting preferences, omit users with no data, and whether or not to include idle time in the report. Once you have your settings configured, you can hit Save Profile to save all these parameters for future use. These report profiles can be used to set parameters in just a few clicks the next time you need an on-demand report, or they can be used with the Email Reports feature to automate sending the report on a set schedule. By default, your report profiles will be automatically updated to include new users or computers as they're added. This can be changed in BrowseReporter's settings menu. By hitting Run Report, you'll generate a report based on the data you have available. You can easily save or print the report by using the icons in the top right corner. If you find that your user activity reports and dashboards contain data that is not relevant to you, you can remove specific URLs or applications from them using the Exclusion List feature. The Exclusion List is a global setting that will affect the reports and dashboards for all groups. In this example, I'll exclude Slack and Gmail from my reports. If you still want your monitored devices to track excluded data, be certain to check Upload Excluded URLs from Clients in the URLs Exclusion List and Upload Excluded Applications from Client in the Applications Exclusion List. Otherwise, this data will not be captured. Next, I'll show you how to use the Email Reports feature. Before you begin, you'll need to configure your email settings by going to Settings, Email Settings. You can have the email reports and alerts sent through your organization's email server, as well as a variety of web email services such as Gmail. How you configure email settings will depend on the email server you use. For more details, please visit the CurrentWare knowledge base at currentware.com/support. Once your email settings are configured, return to BrowseReporter's Manage section and click the Email Reports button. This main screen will show you any currently configured email report schedules. Click the New Schedule button to create a new report schedule. Set the report type to Custom Profile. Choose one of your report profiles. In this case, I'll use the one we created earlier. Enter the email address of who should receive the report. You can add multiple email addresses separated by commas. Select your desired report format, how often you want to send it, and what time you'd like it to be sent. The CurrentWare suite uses the time zone of the computer or server the CurrentWare web console is hosted on to determine the time. When you're ready, press the Add Schedule button in the bottom right corner to save that report schedule. There is also a weekly performance report that can be set up. This report summarizes the productivity levels, web browsing, and application usage of the users or user groups you include in the report. This is most often used to provide team leaders with a summary of how their team spent their time the previous week. The process for setting this up is similar to the report schedule. Under Report Type, select Weekly Performance. Enter the email address of who should receive the report. Give the report a name. Select the users or groups you'd like to have in the report. When you're ready, press the Add Schedule button in the bottom right corner to save that report schedule. Next, I'll show you how to use the Email Alerts feature. This feature will send a notification to designated email addresses when specific activities occur, such as excessive idle time, visiting specific categories of websites, or visiting specific websites. To create an email alert, press the Email Alerts button. This screen will show the currently configured alerts. Press New Alert. Enter an alert name. Add the email addresses you'd like the alert to be sent to. Separate each additional email with a comma. Choose the alert type, then add your desired configurations. The URL alert will send an email alert when a specific URL or domain has been accessed the number of times that you set as the threshold. The number of hits to a website resets after 24 hours. The category alert is similar to the URL alert, except it's based on web content categories. BrowseReporter includes a predefined database of website classifications. These classifications can be customized by going to Tools Reclassification. The Idle Alert will send a notification when the computer has been left idle for too long. This can be used to identify computers that haven't been properly logged out, or employees that have not returned to their workstations as expected. Let's take a closer look at how to set up each alert type. For the URL alert, hit Add Domains and enter the specific website domains you want to be alerted of. Give the alert a descriptive name. Enter the email addresses of who will receive the alerts. Set a threshold number. In this case, I'll set it to 6, so that if one of my users visits YouTube 6 times in a 24-hour period, it will send out the alert. Finally, select the correct users or computers you'd like to monitor and hit Save Alert. For the category alert, you'll follow a similar process. For the idle alerts, enter the desired alert name and the email address of the recipients. Set an idle trigger to determine how long the computer must be idle for before the alert goes out. A computer is considered idle when there is no keyboard or mouse movement for a specified amount of time. The amount of time before a computer is considered idle can be customized by going to Settings, BrowseReporter, Tracking Options, Adjusting the Threshold, and pressing Apply. Coming back to the email alert configuration window, select the days of the week and time frame you'd like the alert to be active for. To prevent excessive emails, you can click the Send Me Only the First Email Alert for Each User per Day checkbox. If you'd like the idle time alert to span across multiple time windows, all you need to do is create a separate email alert for each time frame. For example, you can have an idle alert from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. and one from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. to only receive alerts about idle time during standard working hours. Next, I'll show you how to take screenshots of your employees' desktops using the screen capture feature. In BrowseReporter version 7.0.1, screenshots are taken after specific websites or applications are opened on the user's computer. In future versions, there will be added capabilities such as capturing screenshots at specified intervals. On the main screen of the screen capture window, you will see all of the captured screenshots. The screenshots can be sorted, viewed, downloaded, and deleted from this window. To change from List View to Thumbnail View, hit the View button along the taskbar menu. In the Configurations tab, you will see your currently set up screen captures. From here, you can create a new screen capture profile by pressing the New Capture button in the top right corner. This will open up a new window. Next, configure your screen capture parameters. Add a descriptive name. Select the computers you would like to monitor. Choose whether the screenshots will be taken based on a list of websites or applications. Press the Add Websites or Add Applications button to open a window where you can list the websites or applications you'd like to monitor. In this window, type in the website or application name and press the Enter key or the Add button to add the website or application. You can also use the Import feature to import a bulk list from a text file with each entry listed on its own line. When setting up screen capture parameters for applications, you must use the original file name of the executable for the application. For most applications, this will be the program name followed by .exe. For example, to monitor for the Dropbox desktop application, you would put dropbox.exe. One way you could find the original file name of an application that has been previously used by your users is to go to BrowseReporter's Application Usage Dashboard, scroll to the activity log, click the vertical ellipses icon, and click the checkbox next to the Application Process column. For more details on how to find the original file name of an application, please visit our knowledge base at currentware.com/support. To finish things off, I will show you the privacy-focused features of BrowseReporter. These features are designed to give businesses the ability to limit data collection, retention, and access while improving transparency so they can monitor employees while respecting their privacy needs. Here are the privacy-focused features offered in BrowseReporter 7.0.1. With the tracking scheduler, you can limit data collection to specific timeframes, such as only during standard business hours. You can selectively enable and disable what computer activity data is collected. With the auto-delete scheduler, you can limit data retention by automatically deleting data after a set amount of days. Using the end-user activity dashboard, you can provide your users with access to their own data from the CurrentWare client on their desktop. With the warning message, you can set a custom message that periodically notifies your users that BrowseReporter is monitoring their computer. Using operator accounts, you can limit what groups each CurrentWare administrator has access to and the features they can use. For example, you can give a department leader access to their department's reports and dashboards without providing access to departments they do not manage. First, let's take a look at limiting data collection using the tracking scheduler. For this example, I'll limit BrowseReporter's user activity tracking to standard business hours of 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. only. This configuration could be used for allowing remote workers to privately browse the internet after work, or simply for limiting the quantity of data to more relevant time periods rather than collecting data continuously. Please note that the tracking scheduler also affects BrowseReporter's email alerts. Here's how to limit data collection to business hours only. Open BrowseReporter and set it to PC mode. Press the icon with the ellipses and choose the tracking scheduler from the drop-down menu. Select the group of computers you'd like to limit tracking for. Click on the New Schedule button. Choose if you want to track both URLs and applications, only URLs, or only applications. Set your desired frequency. In this case, I'll set it to weekly and choose not to monitor my users on Saturday and Sunday. I'll set the start time to 9 a.m. and the end time to 5 p.m. Next, click on Add Schedule to save the configuration. Then, click on Enable Tracking Scheduler in the top right corner if it is not already enabled. That's it. BrowseReporter will now only track this group during the scheduled time. In this next section, I will show you how to selectively enable and disable what data BrowseReporter collects. As we continue to add new tracking capabilities to our user activity monitoring software solutions, we know that some of our customers will want to limit what they track to stay in compliance with collective bargaining agreements, workplace privacy laws, and their employees' privacy expectations. Here's how to limit what is being tracked by BrowseReporter. On the web console, press Settings on the left-hand side. Select BrowseReporter. In the Tracking Options tab, you will see all of the different tracking options you can enable or disable. Next, I'll show you how to set a custom data retention period using the Auto Delete Scheduler. This will allow you to automatically delete user activity data after a set amount of days. In addition to helping you meet data retention compliance requirements, reducing the size of your database using the Auto Delete Scheduler has an added benefit of improving the performance of the CurrentWare console and reducing the time it takes to generate reports and dashboards. Here's how to find the Auto Delete Scheduler. Go to Tools, Auto Delete Scheduler. Click the checkbox to enable the scheduler. Select the data types you'd like to automatically delete. Set the retention period. Then, choose when you'd like the Auto Delete Scheduler to run. To limit disruptions, it's recommended that you set the process to occur outside of peak working hours. Next, I'll go over some of the ways you can provide your users with access to their data. One way is to enable the End User Activity Dashboard to give them direct on-demand access to a dashboard with their internet and application usage. You can also have a trusted member of staff walk them through their individual user activity dashboard, or set up report profiles with only that user's data, and use the email reports feature to send them on a set schedule. Since we've gone over the email reports feature and the dashboard will be covered in a separate video, I'll just show you how to enable the end user activity dashboard. You could provide your users with access to their own data by going to settings, Browse Reporter, client settings, checking the allow users to see their own web and app activities checkbox, and pressing apply. This will add a CurrentWare icon in their system tray where they can review their website and app history. This gives your users insights into their own computer activity so they can self-manage their usage and understand the data that is being captured. Next, we'll turn on a warning message that'll periodically remind your users that their computer activity is being tracked by BrowseReporter. To do this, simply go to Settings, BrowseReporter, Client Settings. Click the checkbox next to Show BrowseReporter Warning Message. Enter a message of your choice, then press Apply. Next, I'll show you how to limit what features and data trusted employees can access within the CurrentWare web console. CurrentWare's operator accounts allow you to implement role-based access control to each of the solutions and their features. In this case, we'll use the operator accounts to provide the accounting department manager with access to their team's data without giving them access to the data of other departments. Here's how. Go to Settings, Operators. Select the Add Operator button to create a new operator account. Enter your desired username, password, and description. Select the User Account Type. The Administrator Account Type is reserved for those that need unrestricted access to the CurrentWare web console. Select which groups of PCs and/or users the account can access, and set all of the permissions you want to provide. In this case, we'll only provide access to the accounting group, and give them permission to access BrowseReporter's dashboards and reports. Press the Apply button to save your settings. Then, on the next screen, press Add to finish creating the operator account. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions, you can reach out to the CurrentWare support team at currentware.com/contact, or you can get more information from our self-serve knowledge base at currentware.com/support.